Test, test, 1, 2, here we are again. Okay, we're gonna do some like transitional cleanups here. Some transitional cleanups. All right, let's, it's gotta render this right here. All right, you can see the audio wave. It's okay. It's not pumped. So when you play it, watch the meters.
Well, what I'm...
Oh, see, my clip is really loud. That first clip is really loud. Okay, so we'll cut there. This is really loud. You could tell just by looking at the size of the wave. Okay, this over here is a cut. I could tell just by looking at the wavage. See that? Okay, scoot on over. I could tell there's another wave right here. You could see it, another cut rather. Okay, then here's something big, cut. You actually see it better when the wave is smaller. You could see them jumping out more. There's one right here. Let's see right there. Shazam, ziggity doo wop. Oops. Okay. I'm doing this with the blade. I press B. Here's one. Here's a cut. Cuttage. Okay. Here's a big chunkity chunk over here. You could tell. Right there. All this is fat. So, first thing we're going to do, press A. Get on this big clip here, or this clip, because this one kind of looks the weakest right here. And we're going to go to our effects, open up our effects over here, let's go to the multiband compressor, slap that on and give it an upward compression of +6.
All seem to be in danger right now. This year's election pits Emmanuel Macron, a centrist technocrat with no party, against
Okay, let's throw on the dynamics.
Marine Le Pen, the far-right anti-immigrant candidate for...
Now it looks really nice up to the top. Let's put on this limiter. And this is going to be wrong because it's at negative 20, so it's going to crunch everything down to here.
For Front National.
But we can change this to negative 0.30, so that way it'll never go past right there.
However, many anarchists and anti-fascists attending this year's May Day protest...
You could do negative 0, but sometimes it'll barely peak and hit the red. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to... fix these cuts really quick. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold Alt, click that clip that we just put these effects on. I'm going to right click, left click, copy. I'm going to hold Alt and highlight all of these. Press Shift and undo that one. And then right click over here, paste attributes, and I just pasted all that on every clip. Now, I'm going to come to this first clip and we're going to take those off. Delete. Delete. Oh, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to cross. I'm going to hold Alt, grab all this, and press Control T, which gives me my transition. My transition is set over here under General Preferences. My video transition is set to 60 frames, which is in the case of the 60 frame per second, it's 1 second. Or sorry, rather, yeah, it is 1 second. Okay, here's 0.20 for my audio transition. We could change that, but I think it's okay. So,
well, what I'm talking about is the reason that we have a Second Amendment in there. You know, this is a book of...
Okay, so I'm going to jump over to here for this cut.
They are armed.
Now this became way too loud because we have these effects on it, so I'm going to click delete and delete.
armed.
Okay, what I don't like here is this, the way this fades in. Okay, this should be right here on this white screen, should be where this cut happens. You should not be seeing the TAC TIMES logo through this image. When the TAC TIMES logo is there, it should be completely clear, like that. So this fade that was here was actually about, it was actually about this long. So the only way we're going to fix this is, because I have the original source, come over to my library here, double tap, come into TAC TIMES, and click on TAC TIMES. It's the Big Bang intro. I'm going to open that. I'm going to literally just come and place this right back over here. I'm going to delete that. So right here is where we want this to come in. So if we throw on the cross dissolve here, we don't want this. We don't want that. We want this right here. As we're dragging it, we can see what the image is. We want it to be right before that TAC TIMES logo right there. Okay, now the only problem is over here, we actually have the old video coming in. So we want to actually cut that about here. This is where this needs to meet this. So in that case, I'm going to hold Alt and shrink that down. And then I'm going to bring this up. I'm actually going to hold Alt, connect this right here. This is where it needs to meet. And then I'm going to put my cross dissolve here. And I'm going to pull it in right when I see that. So it's going to look like this. Problem is now the audio. So with the audio, I'm either going to scoot this over with Alt, pull that in right about there, pull that back. Still holding Alt, Control T. Can even close that in there. About there-ish. So that way he finishes what he's saying.
Because they are armed.
Okay, so we fix that. Actually, we didn't. It should be right here. Hold Alt, drag that out. That's where it should be. Put this in, drag it over to right about there-ish. That's it. That's where we need it. Right at the white flash, basically, is where it needs to be, the next clip.
Because they are armed.
And I will set...
Control... Oh, we don't have to fade... Actually, we don't have to fade that, because it was fine.
And I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians, and they shall fight everyone against his brother and everyone against his neighbor, city against city, and kingdom against kingdom.
Okay, so here we go. I will set the Egyptians... Come into Google. I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians. Isaiah 2. What does it say?
I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians, and they shall fight everyone against his brother and everyone against his neighbor, city against city, and kingdom against kingdom.
Okay, so I'm going to come over here to title, new title, default still. If you want to paste your info, you can, you don't have to. Now your title actually shows up over here, and you can bring it in. We're going to set it across this thing, even though there's nothing there yet. Double click it and it opens up here. Click left click for my cursor, paste that, Control V from what I pasted. Okay, so we can actually pull this out if we want to look at it. And I will set Egyptians I'm going to put a backspace and a period, or sorry, backspace and enter, and I will set Egyptians against the Egyptians, backspace and enter, and they shall fight everyone against his brother, backspace and enter, and everyone against his neighbor, backspace, enter, city against city, and kingdom against kingdom. I'm going to press this center button here to center it. I'm going to press these two that are going to center it horizontally and vertically. I'm going to control A, highlights everything. Go to regular. I'm going to make it bold. Actually, what I want to do is change it to, I really like impact, because it's impacting. If I could find it here, impact. It's actually really big. So what we can do is we can actually click on this arrow. Hold shift, actually drag this over, hold shift and hold the corner and shrink it, and then let go of shift and drag it over to the middle, and then double click to get inside, click, hold control and press A to highlight everything. I'm going to bring the leading down a little bit so it spreads out a little bit. Okay. I'm going to just literally click this arrow and place it where I want, maybe up here. Actually, let me double click in here again and press backspace, spacebar, and that looks better. And then I'll bring it up. And then I actually want to come back over here and I want to make sure that I get the reference. Control C, 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 C to make sure we copied it. Come back over here. Come back, double click in there. Press enter. Press control V. We have the phrase. Control A will highlight it. Actually, I don't know if we need a highlight for this, but go to shadow. Click the shadow on. Click the size up to, I don't know, let's see what 10 looks like. Let's see what 40 looks like. Opacity, we can bring the opacity up, try 100. Strokes, add a stroke, add an outer stroke. We added an outer stroke. Stroke can be size 10, I think is fine. I can't really, what we can do is left click, control A, or click on this color, and let's make it like a yellowish so that it stands out. Center it horizontally. Keep it within these safe zones, because depending on when people adjust their TV settings or whatever they're watching on, they might be cropping and losing some of the outer edges. Okay, come out of here. And it's right here now. So let's see what happens.
And I will set the...
It should go right there, yeah.
And I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians, and they shall fight everyone against his brother and everyone against his neighbor, city against city, and kingdom against kingdom.
Okay, so shrink that here. Okay, I don't like the black really here, but it's okay, because I think that's part of the logo. So really, if we want to smooth it out, we can cut here. Press delete. Did we cut off some of the words? Maybe we did. Control Z, undo. Control Z again, undo. Pull this over here. Okay, this is what I don't like. I don't like the black coming in after the logo. I don't like how it fades in from black. So I would rather cut to about here-ish when the picture's already bright. Right when it's about the brightest, drag this over, click here, actually come to this edge here, drag this over, click in this space and hit delete. Come here to this, oh, did I take off the effects on that? Remember, our effects were on here, we can delete those effects because this clip is loud enough. All these stock clips with the TAC TIMES stuff is loud enough before effects are on them, so we can actually delete these effects. Should have never pasted them on there to begin with, but...
Fine.
Okay, so once again, it fades in from black here. I don't really like how that happens. So in this case,
in a church.
We don't really want to cut off their singing, so what we can actually do is get rid of this effect, or this cut. Or actually, let's put it back. Let me see.
Oh, entirely.
Let's see what happens if we put these together without it.
Entirely.
You still hear it because that's what you're hearing it over here.
Entirely.
Now you're hearing it over here.
Entirely.
Okay, I don't really like it. I'd rather like it with the cut, I think. So we'll find the spot where it looks bright, which is about here-ish. And we'll cut all this off.
The status quo entirely.
Now, let's see what happens if we just bring this in.
Quo entirely. In a church near the border with China.
Well, let's put on a effects constant power.
In a church near the border with China, a small service. And the political status quo entirely. In a church near the border with China, a small service was held to mark 1 year since the peace in northern Myanmar was broken. Most of the people in Kachin State are Christian.
It's a cleaner edit.
Independence Army.
Hundreds of Eritreans living
in Independence Army.
Hundreds of Eritreans living in Ethiopia on Friday.
We can take out this these effects that we should never put in there.
Me.
Hundreds of Eritreans living in Ethiopia.
Cut off the word hundreds, but I guess that was already cut off.
Hundreds of Eritreans living in Ethiopia.
Can't really bring that back. That's fine, we can get rid of these effects. These clips will have the effects, these big clips, just not these little ones I've had in between. So we can take it off this one as well. That was my autosave that kicks on. You can set your autosave preferences, autosave. I have mine saving every 3 minutes so I don't lose anything if it crashes.
While French unions step up protests against labor reform.
Okay, that's it. That's too loud, you can kill that. All right, there you have it. All right, so that's good to go. If we want to do a quick overall effect, we can go to the adjustment layer. Sometimes this will mess things up when you have certain effects, when you have certain transitions layered on top of each other. Having an adjustment layer above everything could make a transition actually look very bad. It can actually mess with it. So if you do throw an adjustment layer off, you might want to watch the whole video. If you do throw an adjustment layer on top of your video, you might want to watch the whole thing and make sure no transitions get messed up, or you have to know what you're looking for, what kind of transition. Usually it's when videos are layered above each other. Okay, anyway, that might have made no sense what I was just trying to say, but effects. The Unsharp Mask is a good one. You can find it. Right here I have a favorites folder. You want to add your most used plugins effects in your favorites folder. So the Unsharp Mask is somewhere in Video Effects, Sharpen, somewhere. Distort, no. I don't think it's under Distort. Anyway, you can find stuff right here. Sharp, S-H-A-R-P, and you'll find what things come up. The Unsharp Mask is here. I have it in my favorites, so I'm going to put it on. Usually I boost this up somewhere in the ballpark of like 60 to 100, 70, 80, 90, whatever. Depends what it is. But this one, the radius is the thickness of what you're sharpening. So let's just say you crank this way up. You will see these fine lines, which you can't even really see in here. You zoom in. These fine lines. here. Fine pixelation. Now, if we make this 2, already it makes a huge difference of what was sharpened. Make it 3, makes even a bigger difference. So imagine if you crank this way up, you do some crazy things here with sharpening that you're not really trying to do. So 3 is usually a good one, but right now, because that, you know, makes it a little thicker than 1 or 2. Oh, see, look, you can even go 1.5 if you really want to. So I don't know. I usually find 3 is like a good overall one, but the problem is here it's you're at sharpening at 500 amount. So maybe bring down to 100, and then you switch between the unsharp mask off and on. And if we zoom right back in again to the face, that's a little close. But if we zoom back in the face here, and you click it off, and look at the sharp around the eyes, the nose, and put it on, sharpens up considerably. Now, you can get crazy, and if you want to start layering multiple unsharp masks and have them set differently, you can sharpen thick lines this amount, and then you could sharpen the thinner lines that amount, so you could really get nuts with it. You're only going to do so much, because it is what it is. But let's just say we wanted to do that. Make this like 8. And then drop it down to like 30. So really there's not that much effect. Maybe 20. But it just pops the... There's barely an effect, but you can see it around here. And it's just going to pop some of the fatter lines, and it gives more contrast. So if we zoom back out. So if you have this one off, it's not doing a whole lot. Maybe boost it to 30. But if you boost it to like 60, you will see a big difference. Off, on, off, on. Actually looks really pretty good like that. So maybe drop it to like 50 and then slap this one on top of it and drop this one maybe down to, let's do 70. And this one we could bring down to like 30. And they're together, they equal 100. But this one's doing the fine lines of 3. This one's doing the thicker lines of 8. And now if you were to take this off, you see a big difference of the sharpness and clarity. And then you put it on, it's going to affect every clip underneath this. So we jump over here, take it off, a little blurry, put it on, much sharper. Now the idea is not to overkill it, because you just want to give it a little bit of sharpness and clarity. But you can see a big difference off. I mean, look at this guy's eyes right here. If we just zoom into his eyes, and this is on, this is on, off. His facial features look really blurry now, on, but you run the risk of sharpening too much some of this additional stuff here. So let's say I were to drop this amount, so let's put it at like 50, and then maybe put this at 50. And then turn it off, turn it on, zoom out to fit, turn it, whoops, that's a lot, I locked the track, turn it off, turn it on. Now this clip has this like extra black line here, I don't know why. Looks like something was off, but let's just take that and bring the scale it out to like 105. Actually go 103. 102, and then bring it down with the I guess it would be the Y axis. I could be wrong with that. It's this one. Is it? I think it's usually XY. Anyway, so that kind of expanded out. So if you were to go to 50% and then you were to click on this clip, you actually see that I'm stretched out of the frame a little bit, ever so slightly. Now over here it's not like that, so it just seemed to be like this clip, because if I were to, let's say I were to take this clip, hold alt and drag it up, I just duplicated it. Let's say I were to click this button here, I'm gonna reset all the properties and see how it's back. That black bar is back. If I hide this channel, you see the one underneath it where it's gone. Come over here, click it back, and it's back. But it's not, it doesn't seem, I didn't notice it in any of these other clips. So these are all fine. We could delete this. We don't want to delete that. Let's just, we don't want to delete the audio with it. So you can hold Alt and delete it, or we can just Control Z, undo what we just did there. All right, I think we're good to go. This is pretty much fixed up. I'm gonna run it through again on my own to double check it, but for now, we'll render this exploit. We wanna sit here all day going through this whole video. If you wanna see it, you can go to tactimes.com, T-A-C-T-I-M-E-S, TAC Times, like the New York Times.com, or you can search it on YouTube. And there'll be a whole assortment of videos there. So, export this out to my general spot. And I'm not sure what this video is called, so I'm just going to leave it this for now, and I'll rename it after it's already out. Or if you want to know what you can do here is, let's say I do want to name it in advance. Where is this video? This video is right here. Rebellion, protest against its own. So, okay, so I'm going to click that title. Okay, right here, copy, Control C. And I'm going to actually come over to my thing here, and this is my sequence. So I was working on another video over here, Columbine. It's 8 hours, 8.5 hours, and I'm going to try to see if I can fix some stuff on it. I don't really want to deal with that project, but anyway, if I were to close this, that sequence is gone, but it's actually right here, so I double-click it, and it comes back. So it's like having multiple, let's say, Photoshop images open at the same time, or kind of like your sequences within a project. So over here, sequence two, I'm going to open that up by clicking on it. I'm going to paste the name in there. You'll see right here this changed to my sequence. So now when I click Control E to export, well, I'm going to go on the timeline and click Control E to export, and then pick my settings. Let's just pick this here, and but you'll see already the title is right here as it comes out. The only thing I didn't pick the 8 and the rest of the title, so when it renders out, it's just going to be this. But supposing you wanted a title, you can render it right out in advance, so that when it's done, it will be titled whatever you want it. And here it comes. Here it comes. It should be coming any minute now, any second now. I'm not sure why it's not there. It's very weird. Did I not click OK? It's preparing data for export. This is awkward. There it goes. That was a little slow on its part. So as this goes and you click enter, oh, we're good with that. So as this goes, wow, it says it's going to take 1 hour and 20 minutes, and that's most likely has to be due to the effects, the sharpening effect that was put on there. So let's just say in my case, I don't want to let this all render without double checking my video. So let's say I want to go double check my video, come back to it. First, I just want to pause this, and it's paused right here. Then I can review and watch my video. Now if it's laggy when it plays, you could do one of two things. In this case, you could take the eyeball off the effects, and you'll notice right here anything that's rendered is already yellow. When you put this on, it all becomes red because it's not rendered anymore. It'll lag when you try to play it.
Tensions in France are high.
It'll be a little choppy, so take it off if you just want to watch it without that. Or you can change your playback here from full to half to a quarter, which the picture is going to look very pixelated.
Protesters and police have been regularly fighting.
Actually, it doesn't look so bad. But then you can play it. You can watch it back. I usually keep mine at half. My computer's fairly decent. So I'm going to want to watch that. And then when I'm done, I can hit resume. Assuming it's all correct, I'll hit resume. Otherwise, I'll cancel it. And that's it for now. That's it for now. Actually, I'm going to pause this and watch this again. Because there's no point letting that render for an hour, and then I find something I missed, and then I got to make one minor correction. So I'll watch it first, and then I'll resume that. Okay, there you have it.